Albon ahead, and gap to the car in front. Welcome to Mexico City, the most popular city in North America, and home, of course, to the Mexico City Grand Prix. It's a sellout crowd as usual here at one of the shortest circuits on the Formula One calendar. And who, I wonder, will they be cheering on the top step of today's podium? At 2,285 meters above sea level, the thin air of the Autódromo Hermanos Rodríguez poses a unique challenge, not just to a driver's skill, but to the efficiency of their engines as well. 17 corners then make a lap of this 2.6-mile circuit. Expect incredible speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour and overtaking into the braking zones of Turn 1 and Turn 4. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Magnussen, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Stroll. Verstappen, Albon, Russell. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and more. Gasly, Ocon, Lando Norris. They've taken a grid penalty, and Ricciardo. Fernando Alonso, Vettel, Nicholas Latifi. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty, and Guan Yu Zhou. Sainz and Yuki Tsunoda. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into Turn 1, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up now. Be patient and watch for those lights. Green Park Fermé.
It's victory in Mexico then. And what a victory it is after an incredible Grand Prix. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. Of a knock today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Carlos Sainz would be my first choice for this race. He had excellent race stamina, giving him the opportunity to charge through the ranks.
Let's move on to the constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.